point of the year for North Carolina. They played and lost at the University of Maryland, 106-94. The Tar Heels were beaten on the boards and simply out-hustled by the Terrapins. Dean Smith, in 22 years, has not been beaten this badly very often. For Michael Jordan, a frustrating second half. He was held to 2 points until the game was decided, but still finished with 25 points overall. He's the second leading scorer in the conference, and it's up to Jordan and the Tar Heels' other All-American, forward Sam Perkins, to bring them out of a two-game losing streak that threatens their lead in the Atlantic Coast Conference. North Carolina State coach Jim Valvano would like to make it 3 in a row for the Tar Heels. He has never been able to beat a Dean Smith coach team. And if he does it today, he'll need another superb performance from freshman scoring sensation Ernie Myers. It's North Carolina against North Carolina State. North Carolina, a minute and 21 seconds into the first half, and North Carolina leading North Carolina State 2-0. Because of the length of the first game, you missed the first 1 minute and 20 seconds. And here's an exchange of steals and a foul on number 44, Matt Dawson.
NC State has yet to get a shot off. North Carolina, Sam's Perkins hit one basket. North Carolina starting in a man-to-man defense, and very interesting, Mike, NC State in a box-and-one defense with Ernie Myers on the great player Michael Jordan from North Carolina.
This is Myers, goes to the baseline with Jordan on him, outside to Thurl Bailey, and low is 35. We'll try to set the players for you a few times, get you a little familiar with their numbers if you aren't already. Long jumper, Thurl Bailey. Lorenzo Charles with a baseline rebound and back out to Lowe. Sold out here in Reynolds, 14,600 plus, and here is Jordan with a steal.
Great weak side defense by Michael Jordan coming from all the way on the other side of the floor to knock the ball away from Charles.
Perkins gets himself free for the bank shot, and Perkins with all four Carolina points. 17 and a half minutes to go. First half, Carolina 4, North Carolina State nothing. Lowe, the all-time leading assist man for NC State, trying to catch Phil Ford as the all-time leading assist man ever in the Atlantic Coast Conference.
North Carolina bringing their defense out away from the basket, trying to put pressure on NC State.
Sidney's Lowe's miss is grabbed by Doherty, and the foul on Cozell. Statistics will tell you that the North Carolina State guards average more points than the two forwards in the center combined. Very aggressive defense by North Carolina State, but here's Perkins again. Sam Perkins, 3 for 3 and 6 points, all six.
The first field goal he got, he was wide open, but the last two times, Cozell McQueen was there to bother him. He still put it in the net.
Lowe directing traffic. He and Ernie Myers playing in the backcourt. Thurl Bailey from long range. And Thurl Bailey has his first two.
I think it's important for NC State to get a big game out of Thurl Bailey.
And they say that was a three-pointer for Bailey just beyond that line, so it's 6-3. Doherty to Doherty. Has the ball stripped. Sidney Lowe will let them set the offense. Looks for Thurl Bailey, loads, then goes to Myers.
Great matchup on the floor for the fans at home. Ernie Myers, the scoring sensation.
Lorenzo Charles missed the shot, but tipped in the rebound. 6-5, Carolina by one.
Lorenzo Charles in there close to the basket where he is so strong, followed his own missed shot and tipped it in.
This is Perkins, who has all 6 points, out to Braddock. He hasn't taken a shot. Jordan has been quiet the first couple of minutes. Braddock, a double fake. Perkins, that jump hook, finally missed a shot. State with a chance to take the lead. Here is Lowe, three-pointer. And good hustle outside. Cozell McQueen got to it for Raleigh. Timeout on the court with the score. North Carolina 6, North Carolina State 5.
Statistic thing we should keep an eye on, Mike, is the inside play. North Carolina, in losing two, has been out-rebounded and outscored inside by the big players from Villanova and Maryland. NC State, on the other hand, needs to generate some inside offense to be effective today. Great steal by
Lowe. Took it away from Braddock, and he's fouled by Matt Doherty.
To be able to walk off the court and say nice game to them and be the winner for a, yeah, for a change.
State has lost 7 in a row to the Tar Heels, and Sidney Lowe, a 75% shooter, misses his first. He's averaging almost 11 points a game, but his great value to this ball club is his leadership, his ability to run the offense, one of the best assist men you will ever see in college basketball. Misses both free throws, so North Carolina still has a 6-5 lead.
And freshman Curtis Hunter is in the game for North Carolina.
That's Hunter, 43, to Jordan. They expected a lot from Hunter when they signed him. Injuries have limited his playing time. Brad Daugherty's jumper won't go, and low with the rebound. Sidney averages almost four of those a game. I mean, he can do it all. A lot of rumors going around that Derek Wittenberg would be back today. He is not. He is still badly injured. They are hoping that Derek Wittenberg will be ready for the ACC tournament.
Good steal by Sam Perkins. Those long arms, getting a hand on the ball, knocking it away.
Perkins has all six of Carolina's points. Cross-court pass almost got past Hunter. This is Hunter. Gets inside, and they'll call the foul on Thurl Bailey and give him the basket, so there will be a chance.
Also had lost Buzz Peterson, who had really made an outstanding contribution to the team. Buzz is on the end of their bench today with a cast on his leg and will be out for the season.
Three-point play gives Carolina a 9-5 lead. Peterson had torn ligaments in his right knee. Our condolences to him. An important part of this ball club is they try to defend their NCAA championship. Ernie Myers, who has filled the scoring void at least left by Wittenberg. Derek can do so many other things, of course. Jump hook by Thurl Bailey, the rebound at Daugherty. This is Hale. Daugherty top of the circle to Jordan. Nice baseline drive, but it was knocked away, retained by Carolina. Hunter quickly off the bench. Hunter has 5 points, and it is 11-5. Scoreboard says only 10-5 with 13 minutes and 31 seconds to go first half. Now they've changed it to 11-5. Another bad pass inside, this time ripped away and stolen. Hunter behind the back dribble, got into the lane, and Thurl Bailey took it away.
North Carolina keeping fresh people in the game, trying to put a lot of pressure on the ball, is causing some NC State turnovers.
Low, pressured by Hale. Charles has to come out from the baseline to help out, and Carolina really extends its defense.
This is when you know your defense is effective, when you know you've got NC State starting their offense that far from the basket. Soft rebound effort by Thurl Bailey for two.
Off of Myers' miss, it's 11-7. The margin cut back to four. A little surprised that North Carolina State is in a zone, Jeff?
Well, Jim Valvano said before the game he thought that was the way to beat Carolina, if there was a way. Playing zone.
Another steal by Lowe. Sidney Lowe. That's two for him so far. Myers, three-pointer. Ernie Myers has not had real good rotation on any of those jumpers yet. His third three-point attempt that hasn't gone down. Daugherty gets inside. No call. NC State with the basketball. It was a good job by the official not making a call. Looked like a little acting on both sides.
Nice fake by Daugherty to begin with, but Cozell McQueen got back play, blocking the shot from behind and getting the basketball.
We're approaching 12 minutes left in the first half of play. We're at Reynolds Coliseum in Raleigh, where it's another sellout, 12,400. And if just looking around is any indication, a few standing room on top of that. Low three-point effort. Got an air ball that time, but good hustle by State. Gets the basketball back in their possession. This is the way Maryland beat North Carolina Wednesday night. They simply out-hustled them, Jeff.
And Villanova out-rebounded the University of North Carolina by 9 rebounds, one of the few times it happened all year.
A lot of people will tell you that rebounding is nothing but desire, too. Myers drives, and Hunter probably on the foul, and the foul will go to Hunter. First foul on Chris. The Heels have lost two in a row. It doesn't happen very often, not to Dean Smith. This is Ernie Myers. Free throw, no good. Three free throws in a row. North Carolina State has missed in the early going. Myers, 63% shooter. North Carolina State was the first school he visited. Jim Valvano, the first coach he talked to. Very highly recruited young man. Free throws with 11. The Wolfpack 8. We'll be back after this. Carolina has not tried one, which is a little unusual for them, because Braddock and Hale, good outside shooters, as is Jordan.
Michael Jordan, and of course, that's where Buzz Peterson helped this team so much.
Sure
did. The three-point attempt.
This is Hale. Now North Carolina State has gone to a man-to-man. In into the ballgame, Cecil Exum. His first appearance, his first shot, no good. And Cozell McQueen says, I'm supposed to get the rebounds here. You bring it up.
And NC State has done an outstanding job of giving North Carolina only one shot at the basket. They haven't been getting any offensive rebounds, any second attempts.
Number 30 is Harold Thompson, the 6'5 junior from Rayford, North Carolina, who just checks into the ball game. And he gets his first two, and it's 11-10.
And that's good give and throw basketball. He threw the pass to McQueen, cut to the basket, got it back, and made a nice shot inside.
Dean Smith really gone deep to his bench. Doherty, Warren Martin into the ballgame. That's Doherty in the lane. He drew the foul from Ernie Myers and got a break as the ball went in. And Doherty goes, game, only four rebounds. I think they've been disappointed in his rebounding this year.
Well, Matt never has impressed the statistics. He's kind of the glue that makes this team go, though. Started it last year on their championship team, and he's a fine basketball player.
Free throw by Doherty is good. It's 14-10. Here's the full court pressure. Dinky Proctor who checks in, missed the shot. Thompson went for the rim.
Coming off the bench, get a layup. That time, Dinky Proctor driving to the hoop, getting it in close.
Thurl Bailey missed the shot, but a whistle and a foul. And Bailey will get a chance to go lead. 10 minutes, 9 seconds to go, first half. North Carolina State has lost 7 straight times to North Carolina. Poor free throw shooting is not going to help them turn an upset here.
No, it isn't. And here's an interesting, with 10 minutes gone in the first half, Michael Jordan has yet to attempt an outside shot or a shot in this game.
Free throw again. No good. Follow on the rebound. Good hustle, Dinky Proctor. 14-12.
NC State getting the second shots at the basket. North Carolina only getting one.
Cecil Exum shot, no good. Michael Jordan tipped it in, and Jim Valvano jumping up at the official. He wanted basket interference on that one.
Michael Jordan must have been listening to us. He got his first shot. He also got an offensive rebound on the missed basket by Warren Martin.
Bailey, Proctor. Jumper outside, Earl Bailey. 16-15, the margin cut to one. Nice pass by Jordan to Perkins, but Perkins was fouled. Fouls on North Carolina will inbound the basketball. That's Hale. NC State in the zone. They try the alley-oop to Jordan, and Proctor comes down with it. Now Lowe has his pocket pick. Jordan. Oh, three-pointer. What a play. Michael Jordan makes the steal, turns around, nobody else around, so why not take a three-pointer and bury it?
A lot of players might be discouraged when the ball's stolen. Instead, he stayed after it, took the three-point shot, and as you said, put it in the basket.
Good hustle by Bailey, keeps it alive. Here is a whistle and a foul as Myers tries to go in. Two Carolina players hit the floor, and I think it's going to be Hale with a personal foul for blocking. 19-15, North Carolina.
But not in an ACC school, Earl Monroe. The way he likes to make contact before he shoots, he always jumps in a little bit, trying to draw the foul and then putting it up.
Free throw no good. State has made 1 of 7. They could have the lead in this ball game by a couple if they had just made their free throw.
It's hard to understand when they're at home, too, and there's nobody can bother you on that free throw line. It's just
a little bit better rotation on the ball that time. Most of his shots so far have been almost sideways, like he's coming off the side of the basketball. 19-16, the margin 3. Carolina has led all the way. Hale penetrating on the zone to Perkins. Jordan, nice move to get around Thurl Bailey to the baseline. Shot won't go. Jordan with a rebound and draws the foul. And also how quickly he gets off the floor. 19-16, Jordan with 5 points. Didn't get the roll on the free throw. Carolina by 3 over North Carolina State with 8:38 to go, first half. Jordan puts this one in. The lead is back to 4.
Shooter, and he had perhaps his finest hour of the season against North Carolina over at Chapel Hill, hitting a lot of three-point baskets.
Low double teamed, and bad pass. Out of bounds. Gannon couldn't hold it. That's very, makes less than 2 a ball game.
You took the words right out of my mouth. You very seldom see that kind of play from Sidney Lowe. One thing he does do better than any is protect the basket.
Doherty to Braddock. Looking for Brad Doherty. Instead, they go to Jordan. He's been able to fake Thurl Bailey off his feet a couple of times over on that end and then drive the baseline. Bailey will not go for it this time. The shot is short, no good. And they'll give it up to Gannon. will bring it up against Braddock. To Lowe. They want Sidney to handle the ball as much as possible. He's the man that runs the offense. Cozell McQueen. Bailey just inside the three-point line. Missed the shot. Braddock got a hand on it. They're going to call Thurl Bailey for coming over the back.
Perfect example.
With the score 20-16, North Carolina.
Shooting the ball poorly, but I look for things to get better as the game goes on.
Carolina over 50, NC State under a third at 31.6%. They'll simply have to shoot better than that. They've been doing worse than that from the free throw line, or they would have the lead in this ballgame. Jordan to Perkins, nice touch pass to Doherty. Pretty play.
That's one of the best ways to beat the zone. The quick pass inside, barely touched his hands, and Perkins deflected it to his teammate Doherty for the stop.
Lead back out to a half dozen at 22-16. 7 minutes and 15 seconds on the turning clock from Raleigh. Bailey, not a good pass, stolen by Doherty. Picked up by Warren Martin. Braddock with a three-pointer. Good hustle by Gannon to get the loose ball in the corner. Gannon and Lowe are the guards right now for Jim Valvano. Looking for his first win over North Carolina since he's been the coach here at North Carolina State. Cozell McQueen to Gannon.
You'll notice when McQueen gets the ball, Doherty doesn't even come out on travel.
Thurl Bailey comes out. He gets a breather for North Carolina State. And we've got Lorenzo Charles back in. 6.5 minutes to go. First half, Carolina by 6, 22-16 over North Carolina State. The Tar Heels have led the whole way. Jordan to Doherty, and the jumper, no good, there's Jordan. Holy cow.
Michael Jordan, out of nowhere, I saw him start from the top of the key when Doherty shot. Again, he goes to the offensive boards every time. He timed that one perfectly for the two-hand stop.
8 points for Michael Jordan, 8 of the 24, and it's 24-16.
And he's had those 8 points in the last 4 minutes because, remember, he didn't score the first 10.
Ernie Myers just inside the three-point line. He got the jumper down, 24-18. Here is Jordan. Great pass to Doherty. The shot no good, but the foul.
NC State came out and box and won Michael Jordan early. Made it a little bit difficult for him to get the basketball. Since the last 8 minutes, they've been mostly in the zone, and we've seen Jordan's coverage might not be better.
Doherty hits a pair of free throws. Carolina has hit 5 of 6. State only 2 for 8, and they are down by 8 at 26-18. A good defense against Jordan is lock him in the bus. Ernie Myers. Long jumper that time by Gannon inside the two-point zone, however. 26-20.
We saw Myers do exactly what Jordan's been doing, penetrate the defense and make a nice pass to his teammate.
Perkins jump hook with the offhand. He scored and he was fouled to go up for the other hand.
You know, that's one of the things we talk about, how fine the young players are today, but probably the biggest difference I see is their ability to use their right and left hand so well.
Three-point play for Sam Perkins. He now has 9, and that's the margin, 29-20. Perkins averaging 16 points a ballgame. Myers into the lane, tried to draw the foul, shot wouldn't go. McQueen with a rebound. Good hustle by Cozell McQueen. Low to Gannon.
Michael Jordan comes right out on Gannon. They know he's a very good outside shooter.
There's a nice move by Ernie Myers.
Again, you can see him trying to make contact that time, and then he floated the shot over Doherty.
Perkins fakes the three-pointer. Braddock will take one. There's Jordan again. Finally, the rebound to State. Lorenzo Charles brought it down. Lowe was free through a three-pointer. Ducks inside that line, back out to Gannon. Myers to the baseline, double-teamed, and comes back outside. Lowe trying to penetrate, but you might notice Braddock is just keeping one eye on Gannon. He won't let him loose. McQueen misses the shot. Perkins throws the ball out of bounds. Nice pass to Myers against Doherty. Now double-team, had it blocked. He'll go back up again against Perkins. Had it partially blocked. Valvano was up. He wanted Golden. Doherty cross-court to Braddock. Nice move by Jimmy Braddock to get free for the jumper.
He's got a classic jump shot. He faked the outside shot beyond the three-point play. Ended up with a two-point basket.
31-22, the margin back to 9. We're under 4 minutes. 14,600 people at Reynolds Coliseum this afternoon, and it is a little quiet for Queen. Got the double bounce. Cozell McQueen with a left-hand jumper. He has to take the shot.
Yes, he does. I don't think he meant to bank at that time, but it went in, and it's 2 points.
Here's Perkins. Partially blocked by McQueen, and now Dean Smith is up and wanted a goal. Of course, there's two personal fouls. If they called two, he'll get four shots.
There again, and hitting 95% of his free throws. That's shooting.
He's hit 37 of 39. He says free throws are concentration, rhythm, and confidence. He's got it all going right now.
Who's going to argue with him?
This is a shooting clinic. Gannon, fourth straight technical foul shot. He buried all of them. And from 31 to 24, we go to 31 to 28. We've got ourselves a ball game again.
That's a big turnaround play. We might mention, too, that Coach Jim Valvano on the other end, prior to that play, had thought there was a goaltender.
But four consecutive free throws by Terry Gannon have cut the lead from 7-3, and North Carolina State still has the basketball.
And they have a chance for a 7-point play if they can get a 3-point basket here. Big turnaround in the game.
Well, if somebody fouls the guy who makes a 3-pointer, they get an 8-point play.
And
foul?
Yes. Contact was made around the shoulder.
Renzo Charles averaging only 6 points a ball game. Pretty decent free throw shooter. Hits the first. Now the one. North Carolina State couldn't buy a free throw early in the ball game. Has used the charity stripe to cut the lead to 31-29. Charles will have a chance to cut it to a single point. Sophomore from Brooklyn, New York. Valvano rates him as the most improved player on the ball club. Free throw again, good. 31-30. North Carolina State has scored the last half dozen points, and they're back in the zone.
You can see the aggressiveness in their defense, and listen to their crowd.
Cross-court pass from Matt Doherty to Brad.
Deflected off his hands out of bounds.
State with a chance to take a lead. I think Jim Valvano would like them to get a good shot. Ernie Myers to the baseline with Doherty on him.
And Braddock people in this first half. They're trying to wear down the state offense and the state players.
Lowe, the trigger man, having trouble getting it in bounds.
Taking the ball out of bounds. Of course, he's an excellent passer, but I'm surprised he isn't in bounds to receive the pass.
And they get it to Gannon, who drums it right back to Sydney. Lowe to Charles in the lane, and he scores. And for the first time today, North Carolina State has taken the lead. 32-31.
And that was a real power move inside by Charles. Excellent move.
Braddock to Doherty. Carolina keeps its composure very, very well. Pass into Jordan. Minute 57 to go, first half. NC State, if you joined us late, has just taken the lead for the first time. And Michael Jordan erases the lead with his ninth point. 32 all. Only a sophomore. Can you imagine being another team in the ACC and knowing you got to play against this guy for two more years? He's just incredible. Free throw again, good by Jordan. He has gotten himself into double figures. It's 33-32, North Carolina by one over North Carolina State. We're down to a minute 52 to go. First half of play from a sold-out Reynolds Coliseum. Gannon from downtown. Dean Smith calls out a play, and now Braddock relays it to the ball club. Minute 29.
State in a 2-3 zone. Good hands.
Perkins to Braddock. Fake the shot. Drew the defense out against him. Braddock from long range. Won't go. Tip. Doherty. Brad Doherty. We're tied at 35. Here's a steal. Braddock takes it away. And now he has it taken back by Myers. And Lowe retrieves the loose ball.
You said that last tip was by Brad Doherty. I'd like to see it again because I saw Michael Jordan come out of nowhere and it looked like he might have got it.
All right. I wouldn't doubt it. Gannon
They like to try to keep somebody very close to Gannon. But as you saw last time down court, he doesn't even respect that three-point line. He's about 28 feet away. Nice move by Lowe. Missed the shot. Lorenzo Charles, I think, will be called for the first. Your starter, he averages 19.
I think he'd do better from the free throw line if somebody could guard him. He likes to shoot under pressure. He's too alone out there.
Did not look good on that one. Missed the front end of a one-on-one. We're tied at 35 with 27 seconds to go in the first half. See if Carolina plays for one. And you can see the clock. Jordan will not bother with going for one shot. Jordan with 10 points, put on quite a show. 19 seconds left in the first half. We're tied at 35. And Michael Jordan finally did something wrong. He missed a free throw.
You know, when you think of basketball players with great athletic ability like Michael Jordan, they usually don't have all the things he's got, particularly the outside shooting touch. Jumpers sometimes don't have a soft touch, but Michael has it all.
He is being compared favorably to David Thompson, who was probably the greatest player that this area has ever seen. And if you compare anybody to David Thompson, you're paying him quite a tribute.
There's no question about that. One of the most exciting college basketball players.
11 seconds to go. Here's a great pass to Myers. He scores and he's fouled. Think sideways.
Let's see if he does anything different this time. He's obviously going to concentrate a little more. Still didn't have that good rotation. Had a knuckleball.
Down to 4 seconds. Exum trying to get the ball to Braddock. He does. 1 second. Braddock didn't get off the shot. Carolina right after.
Down the stretch. Wake Forest won today, too, and they're right on the heels of the two leaders.
All right, let's take a look at Wake. At NC State, 37. North Carolina, 36. This is Braddock guarded by Lowe. It is awful hot in this place. Reynolds Coliseum is jammed.
NC State starting in a man-to-man defense. Harold Thompson on Michael Jordan.
And Jordan has the ball low and scores over both Thompson and Thurl Bailey. North Carolina regains the lead at 38-37. Here is Myers. Some contact, no whistle. Braddock almost makes the steal, and then Myers threw it away right into the hands of Sam Perkins. Down court quickly to Doherty. Picked up by Lowe. Sidney will leave him alone. He'll take the shot. Didn't hit it. Brad Doherty followed, no good. Perkins followed, scored, and he's fouled. There's the example of North Carolina's power
talked about all week.
Lorenzo Charles just muscled out of the way by Perkins on that one. Goes for the three-point play and scores. Sam Perkins with 14, and North Carolina leads it now 41-37, and here's the three-quarter court pressure. Charles to Lowe. Lowe really the only one on the ball club who can handle that kind of pressure for North Carolina State that's in the lineup right now. Lowe looking underneath, has to go back out to Myers. Myers forced it up, can't get it. Lorenzo Charles tried for the follow. McQueen tries to follow. Lorenzo Charles! If at first you don't succeed, you have to do very well if we're going to have a chance against Carolina. And he hits the three-pointer. He played tough today.
I haven't seen him play every game, but when he gets the ball 6-8 feet from the basket, I think he's a very good player, and I look for State to maybe get it to him more often in that position.
Jordan dumps it off to Doherty. Might have gotten away with a walk. There was a block. Cozell McQueen to Lowe. Good defense by McQueen. Thurl Bailey, who has not been heard from a lot. Thurl goes to the free throw line. Excellent free throw shooter, especially for a big man. 79%. He scored 8 so far today. Trying to hit double figures. And he can do it right here. 18 minutes, 21 seconds to go in the ball game. We are tied again at 41. Thurl Bailey, the line to the left, can put North Carolina State back on top. And he does. Thurl Bailey with 10.
And NC State got their 6 points the second half, all inside.
North Carolina State in a zone. Jordan penetrates it, dishes it back outside. This is a box and one, Jeff.
They've got Ernie Myers man-to-man on Michael Jordan.
Jordan got free. Shot won't go. Perkins kept it alive.
Responsibility. You can't keep him from getting a good shot as he got that down, but at least you can box him out when he misses and maybe take some of the other ways that he hurts you away from him.
42-41, North Carolina State by one. Trying to keep Jordan from penetrating that lane. Doherty to Braddock.
It's interesting having Ernie Myers on Jordan. He's having to work very hard on defense. Will it affect his offense? Good hustle by Lorenzo Charles that time. He almost got the steal.
And the 30-second clock has expired.
One of the few times it's happened all year, perhaps the first to North Carolina, because they've used the clock very well. Let's give credit to the state defense.
Boy, for sure, they really did a heck of a job on that possession. North Carolina was trying to do a couple of things specific. North Carolina State prevented them from doing those specific things on that possession. Shot clock right now is down to 10 seconds. Low. North Carolina State by one. It's down to five, and Cozell McQueen standing 35 feet away. Somebody needs to shoot one, and Cozell McQueen line drives one up from 20 feet.
Bad shot. Again, give credit to Carolina's defense that time. They made State work. They slowed them down. They were too patient and had to force up a bad shot.
And if you can't really criticize Cozell McQueen, somebody's going to say, what is he doing taking that shot? He had no other choice.
No, he knew there wasn't any time left on the clock. He had to take it.
Perkins, so smooth, goes into the lane, hits the bucket, and away from the ball, Ernie Myers has fouled. So Carolina gets the bucket, and then they get the ball. And Perkins throws up an air ball, and Sidney Lowe hustles into the corner to get it. North Carolina by a point, 43-42, with 16 minutes, 18 seconds to go. Perkins with a steal off a bad pass from Myers, ahead to Jordan. Just into the lane, missed the shot. Including Michael Jordan, a little surprised on that one. Maybe it was too easy.
We saw how high he gets up that time. He got a great look at the basket. Good effort by Thurl Bailey. Sidney Lowe says, hey, let's hold it, slow it down a little bit. Let's try and get a good shot.
Might see Terry Gannon in this ballgame pretty soon. He had some success early. Here is Lowe at the baseline. Sidney Lowe, his first 2 points of the ballgame.
Jimmy Braddock down low. He took advantage of it, got the easy layup, and 2 points.
Braddock. They're looking for Jordan, but Ernie Myers playing him tough. Matt Doherty, long shot, no good. Brad Doherty called for the foul. North Carolina, 43. We'll be back in Raleigh right after this. Bad at all. We're at 14,600 here this afternoon. Of course, these men's rivalries have been going on a lot longer than the women's rivalries. Here is Lowe trying to beat a double team. Gets it to Thompson. To Cozell McQueen now. Over to Lowe. State did a good job that time against the pressure. Jim Valvano up on his feet. He wants his team to call a timeout. Shot clock is down to 7. And they're not anywhere near the basket. Now Lowe drives. 2 seconds left. Sidney puts it up. No good. State has only 4 players on the floor. His first 2 points of the ballgame earlier.
Percentages are much greater when you go to the basket, try and make something happen, than shooting a long outside shot.
There's Dean Smith talking to the official score. That man has just been named to the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame. Dean Smith will be inducted in May along with 5 other greats from basketball. And if there's a coach around that deserves it, he certainly is.
There's no question. He is very deserving, and he's in very elite company. Bill Bradley, Dave DeBuscher, some great basketball players, and, of course, Dean Smith, a great basketball coach.
Sidney Lowe with 4 points, and North Carolina State with a 2-point lead. Hale and Jordan are the guards. Doherty, Perkins, and we've got Warren Martin in the ballgame for Carolina.
State's
big
back
lineup
in their 2-3 zone, and let's see if Michael Jordan gets better opportunities against the zone.
Doherty, nice move down the lane, double pump, shot won't go, but he's fouled.
That's
Matt Doherty, only with 3 points today, averages almost 10, can get his club back within a point by making both. It's now 46-44. 14 minutes, 25 seconds to go. It has been this way most of the ballgame, although Carolina did open up an early lead. North Carolina State caught them, and it's been seesaw ever since. Doherty's second free throw is good. That's 5 points on the day from Matt, and it's 46-45. Dickie Proctor in the backcourt with Lowe. Thompson also in the ballgame. Proctor now goes up front, and they get him the ball at the baseline. Proctor is number 15. Thompson to low. A little bit short right now on outside firepower with that lineup, Jeff.
They don't have very much.
Thompson, long range shot, no good. Perkins with a rebound. Gannon has not played in the second half, and they've got Myers out of there right now to get a rest.
Seems like Coach Valano wants to go with a bigger lineup, but he doesn't have very much outside shooting power in the ballgame.
Jordan with Thompson against him as he comes out to the top of the zone. Doherty, three-pointer, no good, rims the bucket. The rebound, tipped outside, taken to Thompson. Good hustle by Proctor on the boards to get the loose ball to Thompson. And this is Lowe saying, let's run the offense. North Carolina State leads by one, 46-45. Carolina now falls back inside with that man-to-man defense. They're not going to come out very far except on Sidney Lowe. Lowe gets a screen from Cozell McQueen. Shot clock down to 2 seconds. Long-range bomb, no good, and good hustle, saves it. Thompson, then he threw it back into the hands of Sam Perkins. North Carolina State is not getting good shots, Jeff. Doherty left all alone in the lane, and he scores.
Pat Doherty has tried to make something happen. Perkins and Martin.
And Sidney Lowe is down. And Sidney, they're attending to him right now. Geez, you just hate to see this. And I didn't see what caused it. I didn't see the contact that might have done it.
Well, he and one North Carolina player and Harold Thompson went up for the rebound. I followed the play. I saw Thompson get the ball.
See the replay. Lower left-hand corner. You may be able to see it.
Here we see Thompson. There's Lowe. It looks like either Jordan or Hale came down on Sidney Lowe. He might have gotten a forearm.
We'll be back after this message from Bush.
Pressure on all over the court. Knowing without Sidney Lowe out there, they're not as good a ball handling team.
Gannon and Myers are at the guard. Now this gives them some real firepower from three-point range. North Carolina State down by one. That was Lorenzo Charles. Myers looking for Gannon. The problem is nobody really knows how to run this offense except Sidney Lowe, or is really experienced at it. Thurl Bailey in the lane. Nice fake. I think a little surprised that the shot was completely blocked and that he didn't draw the foul. There you see the shooting. Nothing of any consequence for either team. The biggest stat there, the fact that North Carolina has had four more shots. State back in the zone.
Warren Martin did a great job on that block at the other end of the floor. He was drawn off his feet, but he was still able to get the ball. Here's a steal by Myers.
Great steal by Myers. He is fouled by Braddock, and the shot wouldn't go.
Jimmy is only 2 for 6 from the free throw line the first half.
Ernie Myers has struggled there. Free throw good on this one. We understand that Sidney Lowe suffered a slightly twisted ankle. There you get a look at him. He's at the scorer's table. Next dead ball. He'll be back in the ballgame. And I think he's coming in for Ernie Myers. Or he'd be in right now. Myers at the free throw line. Misses the second one. Loose ball. Touched by Doherty. Out of bounds.
And we haven't seen that combination this second half.
There's Gannon, three-pointer, and Michael Jordan
made this season over in Chapel Hill. They're calling him Superman. Great inside pass. Lowe to Bailey.
Thurl Bailey got loose, and Sidney Lowe, as he almost always does, found his man. It is 49-47. North Carolina State by two. Trying to beat North Carolina for the first time in 8 straight games. Braddock, three-pointer, in and out. Tough shot, whistle. Be just an ounce or two over that, and when he leans in on you, you know somebody is leaning in on you. 49-47, State by two.
That last foul by Martin, that's the kind of foul that coaches don't get too upset about. That's what you call an effort foul, trying for the rebound.
Lowe against now a man-to-man defense, has to give it to McQueen and gets it right back. Double team, dribbles through the double team, some contact, no whistle, to Gannon. Shot clock down to 5. Down to 2, and Lowe from downtown can't hit it. Perkins with a rebound. Almost lost it. Gannon got a hand in there to Braddock. Jordan.
Very subtly, the North Carolina pressure defense has made North Carolina State use a lot of clock before they get a shot off. Steal by Lowe.
And Lowe is knocked to the floor from some contact as Jordan went after. of the ball. The State people wanted a foul, might have deserved it on that one. Three-pointer, Jordan.
Yes.
It was Jordan that knocked the ball away from Lowe. Carolina recovered. Jordan with the three-point basket.
There aren't words good enough to quite describe the young man. 50-49, North Carolina by a point. Thurl Bailey, long jumper. Didn't get the roll, the tip by McQueen, no good. McQueen with a rebound, and he's fouled. Good hustle by Cozell McQueen. Only 2 points today, in and out. Something of a line drive shot could have gotten State into a tie, or maybe given them a lead if he hit both. Braddock. Time not a factor yet, 9 minutes, 54 seconds. Shot clock down to 10. Shot clock's down to 5. Hunter to Braddock. They don't seem to realize it. They get it to Doherty. Shot clock at 1, and it goes off.
And the clock, it's in the corner, not above the basket. A little bit more difficult to see here, but that's twice that it's happened to North Carolina.
That's right. Carolina has lost the ball twice because they never got off a shot. There's the timeout on the court with 9:17 to go in the game. The score, North Carolina State 51, North Carolina 50. We'll be back after this.
Mike, they're getting great efforts each night from Perkins and Jordan, but they're really missing that other player that can give them a lift. When they had Buzz Peterson, it was usually Peterson or Braddock or Doherty that would give them the lift. Without Peterson, they've got one less player that can do it.
Hale is in the ballgame. Shot clock again, a factor. It's down to 4 seconds. Hale, three-pointer, and he drilled. Great shot by Hale. Puts North Carolina back on top, 53-51, and that was out of necessity.
Yes, it was. A big basket coming off the bench. It's particularly tough.
15 turnovers for each ball club. Not the kind of basketball either coach really relishes. Certainly not the kind they teach. Gannon, nice pass to Lowe. Baseline drive, tough break, shot wouldn't go. Lorenzo Charles kept it alive, but Brad Doherty got the rebound, playing with four fouls. To Hale. Young man from Jenks, Oklahoma. Gets it to Matt Doherty. Looking for Perkins, can't find him. North Carolina has been very, very patient. There's Doherty. No good. Tipped outside. Good play by Hunter. Blocked by Cozell McQueen. They'll call him for the foul.
And at the free throw line was a great high school player last year, and he's a fine athlete.
Out of Durham. 6'4", 191 pounds. They feel he'll be a great ball player. Hits the first free throw. 54-51. Carolina's lead is up to 3 with 8:01 to go.
He's the perfect guy that could give this Carolina team another lift in place of Peterson. He's coming back from a stress fracture in his foot, so it's going to take him a while to work back into the lineup.
Doesn't arc those free throws very much, but he put two right through, and now North Carolina's lead is a little bit more comfortable at 55-51. Got a timeout on the court. 7:57 left to go from Raleigh. The score, North Carolina 55, North Carolina State 51. We'll be back with a stretch run.
Second half. They're not getting into their offense soon enough to get a good shot. We've seen them had to force it up. They need to start right away into the offense and try and get it in close to the basket.
Michael Jordan back in the ballgame, playing with four fouls. Carolina in a zone. You see Jordan coming out on his side.
See, State has made about 6 passes, but they've yet to get the ball out inside the top of the key area.
Shot clock is down to 5 seconds. Sidney Lowe from three-point range may have been tipped by Jordan. Out of bounds to North.
Need about 8 passes, used about 28 seconds, and had to shoot a 30-foot shot.
You're right. Like that old Church League offense, just pass it around, a 2-3 zone. There's Thurl Bailey.
That time they got it to Bailey at the free throw line. They got into the inside of the zone, able to make something happen.
55-53. Jim Valvano's club closes within 2 points. 7:05 left to go in the ballgame. Perkins being guarded by Lorenzo Charles. State forced into a man-to-man right now. Here's a double team out to Jordan. Myers left him all alone, and he missed his shot. Perkins knocked it out of bounds.
Hair, I'll tell you, it'll turn gray when you leave Michael Jordan alone to go double team somebody else.
That's right. Here's Lowe to Myers. Got some firepower in that lineup right now with Myers, Gannon, and Lowe. All of them can hit that three-pointer. Looking for Gannon. Shot clock down to 10. There's Myers. Long range. Just barely nicked the front of the rim. Ernie Myers has not had a good day shooting from outside. Here's Neal. Baseline drive. Foul on who? Only hit 2 of 4 from the free throw line today. And has 16 points. He could tie this ball game up again. Good look at the young man from Seton Pleasant, Maryland. He's already been selected to play in the Aloha Classic, Jeff, and that's quite an honor. Not a bad trip, either.
You know, he's an exciting kind of ball player to see in the ACC. We get a lot of players who come in very heralded. He did not, but he's made himself into a basketball player and become an outstanding.
Well, he did a good job making himself into a player. It's 55-55, 6 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Who is going to have the lead in 2 minutes when that shot clock goes off? Matt Doherty to Jordan. Doherty again against Lowe, lost control of the ball, and who gets it underneath Michael Jordan in his spot?
Mentioned throughout the game that Myers has been guarding Jordan, and that is a chore. Takes a lot of effort, and I think it has affected his offensive play in the second half. He had 8 points the first half, but he's been short on his shots. He looks a little tired out there, and I think it's wearing him down.
Jordan, after missing the first, hits the second. Carolina by one. There used to be that old axiom, you can always wear out a scorer by making him play defense on the other end. And maybe because Jim Valvano needed his defense on Michael Jordan, he gives up that offense at the other
side.
It's
not like Coach Valvano had another choice.
That's
he's
right.
Probably the best choice to guard Jordan.
I agree with you 100%. Here's Gannon. They'd like to get him free for one of those three-point efforts. Myers to Gannon. Shot clock at 4, and Gannon. Oh, count from the parking lot.
He was looking for a 4-pointer that time. That had to be a good 5 feet behind the 19-foot line.
NC State by 2 at 58-56, and Ernie Myers is going to be called for a foul. I think he held Michael.
The power of Myers on the floor.
What would happen if Derek Whitford were here?
Certainly that would be an alternative.
Jordan, nice move to get around Myers, but couldn't penetrate any farther. 58-56, State by 2. Braddock. Doherty. Carolina being very patient. There's Jordan. Penetrates, gets it off to Perkins. But the call will go against Jordan. If it does, that is his the first one. 59-56. Clock now a factor. 5:04 left in this ball game. Sidney Lowe with 5, looking for 6.
And you know that last play is where we hear the term air rights used a lot. Michael Jordan stays in the air, and he really had left his feet, and Sidney Lowe moved into that space. So it is a very difficult call to make, particularly with a great leaper like Jordan.
I think it is the most difficult call any official has to make. Here is Lowe with a steal. Gannon.
Big basket. That's the kind of shot that gives coaches gray hair. They didn't have to take it, but Gannon said, I feel it, and it went in.
63-56, and this place is going crazy. The ball back, the shot clock will be off. Right now it is down to 5. Hunter. Girl Bailey with a rebound. The shot clock is off. We're at 4 minutes and 9 seconds.
Jim Valvano off his feet, giving a signal. Great effort by Curtis Hunter for the steal.
What a job by Hunter, and who gets the foul? Is it Hunter or Lowe? It's going to be called on Hunter.
So much to their offense. He's not out there now. Somebody else has to help.
so Myers will have to shoot one and one rather than two.
There is no lack of brains on that ball club. Fouled the right man. The free throw is no good. Perkins with a rebound. Here's Braddock, calls out play number one against the North Carolina State zone. They're going to make him try to run it from the outside.
Well, they're in a 1-2-2. I think they anticipate that they might try and set a pick for Braddock, and that's a good way to stop a point guard man-to-man.
There's Braddock, three-pointer. Didn't get this one. And the rebound to Lorenzo Charles, and he's fouled. Front end of a 1-1. You have to make the first to get the bonus. And he missed it the second straight time down court. The North Carolina State has missed the front end of a 1-1. We've got 2 minutes, 56 seconds left to go in the ballgame.
Jimmy
State
Braddock is one out of two from the three-point line down the stretch. But North Carolina can go for the good inside basket. They've got plenty of time left. They're just down four.
Hunter, nice feed to Perkins. That little jump hook that he likes so much.
Good play by Hunter, and that's good percentage basketball. Get it in if you can. If you can't, then take the three-point shot.
No sense to try to get it back all at one shot. 2 minutes, 39 seconds left. North Carolina State, 63. North Carolina, 61. We'll be back right after this.
12 in the second half, but they've missed their last three, the front end of 1-1.
Potential 6 points. They beat the pressure. 2 minutes, 31 seconds left to go in the ballgame. State by two. Here's Gannon. Maybe the best free throw shooter in the country is in the ballgame right now. They want to keep the ball in his hands because if you foul Gannon, he's going to score. Lowe, double team. Now triple team dribbles through it. Good effort by Sidney Lowe.
State doing a good job of keeping the ball in the shooter's hands. Sidney Lowe, Terry Gannon, Burrell Bailey's the only other person that's touched the ball. Look and see if Cozell McQueen touches it or Charles. I'll bet the Carolina players foul him right away.
They burn 30 seconds off the clock. We're inside 2 minutes. North Carolina State by two. They are loath to give the ball to anyone but these three guys. Bailey comes outside. Has to pick up his dribble. Might be in a little trouble now. Gets it to Lowe. 1:43 to go. Hale after Lowe to Gannon. You can bet Braddock isn't going to reach it and just hack him up.
They don't want to foul Gannon. They prefer not to foul Lowe, although there's Curtis Hunter reaching it.
Almost a 76% shooter.
Well, I think despite his field free throw percentage, if Galvano could pick one player to go to the line, I think it'd be Sidney Lowe.
Rattles that one home. Senior, 663 career assists coming into this ballgame. Only Phil Ford ever had more in the Atlantic Coast Conference for a career. Free throw this time, no good. 64-61, the margin is three. Braddock stolen by Sidney Lowe. Braddock free throw line, 1-1, and he missed it. So both teams have had a little trouble, and Sam Perkins immediately commits to personal and great on these free throws. A lot of line drive in these. That one had a little more arc, but it's short. Neither team has taken advantage of free throw opportunities that could ice this one. We're down to 1:16 in the ballgame. State by three. Doherty, three-point shot, no good. Burrell Bailey with a rebound to Lowe. To Gannon. 1 minute, 6 seconds left. State trying to pull the upset. In hand, North Carolina, its third straight loss. Lowe to Bailey. 56 seconds to go in the game. Burrell Bailey will not go for the bucket. Instead, gives it up to Lowe. Sidney will come back outside. We're down to 44. State doing a great job. Sidney Lowe gets the first.
Boy, you don't think that feels good? I'm sure it does. And the fans in Reynolds Coliseum really love it.
65-61, State by four. 36 seconds to go. They lead by five. And Sidney Lowe has 9 points. And now Braddock will have to try to get one up from outside. Doherty drives all the way underneath. Tries to draw the foul, doesn't do it, goes up strong, and this time he did draw the foul. 75% shooter at the line to the right. His team down by five with 26 seconds left. pressure free throw.
And we know as we go down the stretch, we got to think of Buzz Peterson sitting on the end of the Carolina bench out for the season. But this is a classic example of where Carolina could have used his great outside shooting.
Doherty's second shot is good. 66-63 with 26 seconds left. Both clubs shuffling their lineups a little bit along with the situation. NC State was going for the home run ball there. Sidney Lowe double team. Here's the long pass to Thurl Bailey. Bailey saw the lane was cut off, so instead he goes back. Thurl Bailey, 4 out of 6. He could ice it maybe right here. Missed the first, goes in. 66-63, believe me, it isn't over yet. Cosell McQueen, and look at Cosell McQueen. After missing his first two and being a 66% shooter on the year, he may have hit the biggest free throw of his life.
Yes, he did, and you think this second one isn't a little easier after you hit the first one?
He could have thrown that one up behind his back. 68-63, Braddock outside the three-point range, lost the ball. Three-point attempt.